I don't know, maybe we'll have crew update?
Hey, Ryder. Thinking about our run through the Archon's flagship. Word of warning. You die again, I'm taking it to HR as emotional abuse. Stop it.
Haha. Very funny.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Drac?
Colony just calmed in. Scouts are expected to arrive soon and medics are on standby.
Good.
I won't forget this, Ryder. You chose Krogan first. It's been a long time since anyone's seen us as anything other than cannon fodder.
You're one of ours.
I couldn't let you down. My crew is like family.
Only family I've had for a long time is Kesh. Guess anything can change.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
I need to check my stuff here. Pardon me. We got 100 Milky Way research data. Minerals. Consumables. Biominerals. Tech materials. Credits. And that's it. Commerce pods. Improve prices. This is what I'm looking for, I think. Trade capacity. Strategic placement of Nexus resources increases the capacity for trade and transport. Oh, that includes it? No, that inventory. I want, like, consumables, right? Consumables. That's can be purchased. I want the amount of consumables that can be held. Can't do any of that yet. Hidden caches. Oh, really? That's interesting. Reveal hidden caches around established forge station. 10% bonus to XP gained for completing encounters. Unlocks one extra consumable slot. That's what I want. Always prepare. Nexus Security develops a method for squads to carry more gear into the field. Alright, always prepare. Let me just look at these. An additional 15% credits for each completed Apex mission. And a 20% chance to receive weapons or armor when Apex mission is completed. Let's take this one. Done. Now we used up all our points. I can't put it anywhere else. Okay. Cool, cool. I'll head back and check in on those three and check email. Hey, you're standing where Drac stands. Gil. Is this your favorite spot now that you finally moved? You stand here?
Hey, you're two for two.
What do you mean?
Huh?
Two times face to face with the Archon.
Oh, okay.
Two times you spit in said face. Figuratively speaking, of course.
Maybe literally.
We were nose to nose this time. Some spit might have hit the mark.
That's a two-way street, Ryder. Ugh.
I know.
Bastard's trying to exalt us all, huh? That's what all this is about.
Could be.
Guess so.
Typically, I like high-stakes games, but I'd rather be sitting at the kiddie table this time.
Don't blame you.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
I'm gonna drop down. Vetra is behind me, and Giles over here.
Vetra, you realize that even if I do find it, it's gonna cost you.
And you know I'm always true to my word, so just get it done.
Shady contact.
I'm hearing the Ket activity's down. I bet the Archon's still nursing his wounds. That means he can be beaten. The Ket can be beaten. People are waking up to that.
Yeah.
Didn't sound like you were discussing Ket over comms when I walked in, though. Wasn't. I have a friend keeping a lookout for a lamp. One brought from home, but stolen in the revolt.
That's so sentimental.
I didn't think you were so sentimental. I'm not the only one. Suvi has her father's antique instruments, Cora her Asari prayer book, and Liam has the junk that Liam collects. These things are important. They remind us where we came from.
I feel the same.
I know what you mean. I never want to forget what I left behind. Even as we look forward to the future. Yes. So what's so special about this lamp? It's awful. It's got a butt-naked Asari for the stand, and she's holding a moon.
Sounds
One
awesome.
Of your prized possessions is a really ugly lamp. The foreman at my first job had this lamp. When he was mean, I'd focus on it so he wouldn't see me upset. Now I keep it so I remember where I started. Most of my life was doing stuff to survive, taking shit from assholes, or being one. I don't have to do that anymore. I can start over. Something honest.
So a naked Asari holding a moon. Sounds ugly? Quite the opposite, in my opinion. And waste your skills?
Do you really want to start over after everything you've been through?
I don't know. The point is, I have the choice of changing if I wanted to.
True.
For a while, I didn't care that I'd lost the lamp. Everything was a mess, and it just didn't matter. But we've made progress, Ryder. Small things matter again. People are daring to dream.
I'm dreaming of someone. small heart? I like the sight of you.
It's nice seeing you like this.
I know. I like being able to let go and do something for myself for once. Let's hope this is just the start, huh?
Anything else to say?
I feel like things are finally going our way, for real. Getting the Solarians back, that's huge.
Yep.
I just wish we could have saved Rika, too.
Couldn't agree more.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Oh. Joel.
Liam's idea about watching vids together.
Yeah, about
movie night? He delayed again, out of respect for Reika.
Good. From what I've seen, your vids are flat. They're only seen and heard. Angara vids use tiny electrodermal signals. You feel it through your skin. I spoke to Gil. We have time to rig up a system to mimic it, if we can acquire the right components.
Is that safe?
Would that be safe for non-Angara?
I think so. Gil will be happy to test it. The components we need should be sold on Aya. Let's be vigilant.
Always be vigilant. Obtain components from the Aya market. Okay. Movie night again. I was kind of wondering what was going on with that. So, like if we watch, like, Die Hard, when he gets shot, we feel it? That kind of thing?
Ryder, what a victory.
I know, right?
Now that we know where Meridian is, the Archon's downfall begins.
Exactly.
A victory feels good, and there's more to come.
You have a good team here, Ryder.
Yeah, seems to be working out okay.
If you'd like, I can provide crew training about embracing emotions.
Oh, okay. I'll think about that.
Okay, let me know.
Embracing emotions?
I'll see you later, doll.
Stay strong and clear.
What are you doing with your hand? Okay, he's talking, but... Okay, you're getting a little eccentric over there. Lexi, I guess?
We need to talk about Sam.
Dr. Tapero does not approve of how we escaped the Ket containment field on the Archon's flagship.
Oh yeah, dying and stuff.
By stopping the Pathfinder's heart. No, I do not approve.
Yeah, I didn't think you would. It was the only way.
We didn't have a choice.
Believe me, I didn't want it.
If there had been another option, I would have taken it.
How can you be so calm about this?
Because I'm alive
Ryder,
still?
Sam killed you. Yes, he brought you back, but what if he didn't?
I cannot learn without the Pathfinder. That would be akin to killing a part of myself.
Your lines of code. You can't die.
Sam is designated or designed to help me.
Hurting me goes against Sam's design.
Because AI have never acted against their designs before. Look, I'm not against Sam. I'm not against you, Sam. But my job's hard enough without an AI stopping your heart. Even to save your life.
Well, if he had not done that, I'd still be aboard the Ket ship, probably being ascended or some crap. Would that be better? Would you be pleased with that? So yeah, noted.
Your concern is noted, Doctor.
Of course it has.
Lexi, I apologize for any distress I have caused you.
And I'm sorry for calling you lines of code. You're more than that. Even if you don't have cells to prove it.
Yep, go run away. See if she has anything else to say.
Ryder?
Oh, yeah. New memory fragment. Is this the one, the final memory of our mother's death?
I saw another memory that Dad locked away. The day my mom died.
I'm sorry, Ryder.
She's why Dad came here.
We each have our reasons for coming here. Mom was his. Her death fueled him.
Grief can be a powerful motivator.
If you can't run from it, use it. Guess that's what he did.
Yep.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Someone will probably be in here. Oh, Cora.
Got a minute? I could use a favor.
Sure.
Sure. What do you need?
I kept thinking about Sarissa and my not being a Pathfinder. And the thinking turned into a project on Eos. Can you help me finish it?
What kind of project?
I'll put the nav points in the helm. Come along and I'll show you.
Go to Eos with Cora. We just came from Eos.
That Archon barely sees us as sentient. Strings people up like puppets. Didn't know Sam could do that to his Pathfinder. You sure you're okay?
Still a little shaken up.
Physically, I'm okay. The rest, it was a lot to handle.
Talk to Lexi if you need to. Or me. Losing another Pathfinder is bad enough, even with the Krogan safe. Sorry, rambling. Did you need me?
I don't think you have any more war stories. Let me check.
Any more Commando war stories?
That's all I can share, anyway. I miss them.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
See if anything new on the info board. Yeah, two new things. Comparative religious study meetup. We did these on a Nexus and they were always fun and interesting, Bring your own text to study, or just come listen to others discuss theirs. Sign up below so we have a rotation for coffee. Suvi. The comments, Jal and Callow signed. Cool. Angaran word of the day, Vesagara. Uprooted people. Used to speak impolitely of those from the Milky Way. Say, Vesagara. From Jal. Comments. Liam says, not as bad as it could be. Spelled like it's sneered. Jal says, it is used mostly by the Rokar. To be fair, one doesn't get more uprooted than being a galaxy away. Suvi says, is it Vesagara? Or Vesagara? He has not answered that one. Interesting. I like the board. Anyone else up here? That's a SAM node. Let's see if the SAM node here has anything else to say. Or anything new to say.
Hello, Sarah. Your choice aboard the Solarian Ark was not an easy one. Your father approached such moral quandaries differently.
I'm sure he did. He was a soldier.
Dad was used to making snap life or death decisions.
I now know that colored his perceptions. Alec treated death as a problem to be solved. I have now encountered it several times. His death, and your own.
Any insights?
And what have you learned about dying from us?
The self is forged by experiences. Death is the only experience that ends the self before it's understood. So, is death completion? Or an expression cut short before it reaches its full solution, giving a different answer? I can see why it fascinates you.
It's very philosophical, especially from an AI.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Check in on PB. Hello, Pelisaria.
Hey, are you okay? I shudder to think what the Archon meant to do with you. And I hated watching you die like that. I think of myself as daring and death-defying, but you?
That's very cool that they put this in, because she might not have even been on our team. And then she'd have a different line. I did what was necessary.
I did what I had to get us out of there.
You're made of strong stuff, Ryder. Just don't get yourself exalted, okay? That asshole means to ketify us all.
Can't let that happen.
Ketify.
But he's close. He's almost figured out Krogan. It's the scariest thing. Ugh. Let's talk about something else, okay?
Let's see if she says anything different.
I like it when you flirt. I wouldn't want you.
Have I flirted with you? Don't worry, Ryder. I'm relentless. It relaxes me.
Yeah, nothing new, okay.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
Wait. There's an option there about Meridian. It was grayed out, though.
Hi there. Just checking in. What's up?
Meridian.
So what's your take? Is this Meridian what we think it is?
Everything we've seen, each remnant system we've uncovered, is connected to everything else. The bots, the monoliths, the vaults. It stands to reason that activating Meridian will connect the entire network and rekindle terraforming across the cluster.
So you think we're doing the right thing?
Well, yeah.
Well, yeah.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
All right. Let's check our email really quick. We have a bunch. Message from New Tuchanka. Cool. Troubling Ket activity. From Nakmor clan. Pathfinder. Nakmor scouts recently returned with a troubling report. Two Ket ships crashed on a plateau on Elladin after taking damage flying through the Scourge. One scout swears she saw one of the ships firing upon the other as they went down, but we are unable to verify this claim. Really? One Ket ship firing on another? If there are survivors from this crash, the desert will quickly claim their lives. However, we believe the circumstances surrounding the crash unusual enough to warrant bringing to the attention of the Pathfinder the Nakmor clan of New Tochanga. Well, if there's actual, like, a rebel force of Ket who will be on our side, that would be freaking awesome. Wisdom from the Moshai Sepha. How do you say that? Okay, so she's writing it to Ryder, but it's translated. Can't she write it in English? If you intend to fight the Ket, you should understand that enemy as we do. There are still a few of us who remember what it was like when the Ket first came, and how our lives change once we discover their true intentions. Learn what our elders have to teach you. I've told them you're coming and given you the means of finding them on Aya. With respect, Moshai Sepha, whatever. Kerry's in trouble. From Hakim Barakat. Ryder, I'm Kerry's producer for the documentary. Something's happened. Come by when you're on the Nexus. Next, we should talk. Hakim. Okay. Just checking in from Korra. Reports from the Archon's flagship sounded pretty harsh. Hope you're doing okay. Well, we just spoke. Something that gets me. When I can stop thinking about what happened to the Salarians and the Krogan, is all those remnant artifacts the Archon had. This isn't just a mission for him. It's an obsession. I've fought people like that before, who only have one thought in their head that burns everything else away. They get very dangerous, very fast. Watching your back. Korra. One more try. From Gil. The Angara have a Bara where PB got tipsy. She's a flirt, even alert, but sauced, she's a pixie. 60 hours straight, keeping your ship afloat. Does it show? Gil. You okay? From Liam. Just putting this out there. Had a friend on the HUS T1 Dondi. We were clearing a hospital after an earthquake and she got hit with a chunk of rebar. Split her helmet, kept going. 4 minutes technically dead, but we got her into emergency stasis. Thing is, because they're so good at patching people up, she was back with us in a week. And she shouldn't have been. Sure, Dondi's a vet. She's seen some shit, but you don't walk that off. She worked that quake site for a week, then disappeared for 5 months. She came back, but different. The other vets, they knew. Take the time if you need it. You don't die and just shake it off. Costa. Liam has included a list of media themed to survivors. Genres include war documentaries and a series of Salarian short films about the Ever Alert. I just want to sneak up on these. Nope, can't do it. Angaran Guns. From Drac. Everyone wrote me. Man, Ryder. I thought I knew guns, but this Angaran shit? They really know how to make things to point and shoot. Was eyeing a couple on Aya when we were there. A sidearm called a Zephyr, and a sniper rifle. Ishare, I think they called it. Looked fancy, but I guess even their shivs are fancy. You think I got one of those Ishares? Glad we found aliens who know how to fight. Not sure how I would feel if Andromeda was nothing but Pyjax or, Elcor. Aw, I'll take Ket over those chumps, Drac. I miss the Elcor so much. You don't understand. About Sam, from Lexi. After our last discussion, Sam and I thought it best if we both took a crash course in AI history to gain a better understanding of each other's perspectives. It's been immensely helpful in finding common ground, but also for highlighting the differences between Sam and the Geth. The Geth didn't need the Quarians to survive, but Sam cannot carry out his primary functions without a Pathfinder. I still don't like that Sam has the ability to stop your heart, but I no longer have nightmares about him getting trigger-happy with your life, Lexi. Okay, three more. Stress-relieving hobbies. From Lexi. I'm encouraging all crew members to take up stress-relieving hobbies. Everyone, especially you, is under a lot of pressure. While taking up knitting may seem a waste of time, such activities release endorphins that clear clutter from our brains so we can solve tough problems and make better decisions. You don't have to choose any of the activities below, but I thought they might jog some ideas. Gardening? Okay, we don't have a hydroponics bay on the ship. We have to go to the Nexus for that. Reading, knitting or crocheting, coloring or painting, journaling. I'm always here to talk if you need me, Lexi. Communication from Jal. I'm writing to let you know I've been receiving a lot of messages of congratulations from Resistance members who've heard of our victory against the Archon. It's not common knowledge, but it's hard to keep good news like that from spreading. We are hopeful people who are granted new hope. Imagine the excitement when we conquer Meridian and heal the cluster for all our people. Some nights I can't sleep because I'm dreaming of it. Jal. A communication concerning movies. From Jal, Ryder. Liam's talking about a movie night, but when he explained, it sounded lacking, at least compared to Angaran vids. Perhaps I can add what's missing. Come talk with me, Jal. He sent that before we talked to him. And that's it. Alright. Speak with Carrie's producer. Speak to Dennis. And now speak to a bunch of people on Aya. Dissension in the ranks. Check your email. Yeah. Investigate the crash. Catch shifts on Illidan. Alright. Save Suvi for last. Save the best for last. Hello. I'm just excited Suvi might see something new. It's been a while.
A real victory. Our Ark back at the Nexus. I'd almost given up hope.
You doubted me, Callow?
I find things, Callow. My job description's only one word.
Losing Pathfinder Reka is a blow. So many Salarians joined the initiative because of her. Yeah. But you did your best. Did you need me?
Probably nothing here.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
No. If I gossip any more, I'll get in trouble.
You know, I haven't actually met...
Chosen one.
I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
Tell me something else about the ship.
O'Connell, our systems designer, was running a power distribution, but he forgot to... For 2 days, poor O'Connell was convinced that turning on all the... You know where I'll be.
Yeah, I heard all that before. Okay. Suvi.
I need a break. Do you need a break? Let's go for a break.
Okay. Awesome. Going for a break. Yay.
Tea, Zeta?
I'd love a cup.
It's a cultivar originating in Sumatra. My own personal stash. Once I run out, that'll be it for Earth tea.
That stinks.
I keep having these thoughts. I'm never gonna taste this again. I'm never gonna see that again.
I get those thoughts too.
You're not the only one, Suvi. I have those senseless thoughts all the damn time.
And? Do they bother you?
Yeah.
It's natural. You'd have to be made of stone not to miss home sometimes.
The universe is like a giant tapestry. I love following its threads. But it distracts me from the whole picture. My family was right there. But I was too occupied by the abstract to appreciate them.
You're here because of family.
From everything you've told me, you're here because of your family. Your love of science, doesn't that come from them? Aren't you with them every time you chase down a new discovery?
Right.
Ryder, that's beautiful.
My mother made the implant in my head, and my father created the AI that uses it. I haven't lost them either. And Suvi, the threads you followed led you here to me. How could that have been a mistake?
Ooh,
of everything I've encountered in Helios, you are by far...
Favorite?
Sarah, don't do this to me. Not unless you really mean it.
I don't know. PB, Suvi, Suvi, PB... But PB doesn't really want to get close, does she? I think in the end she would. I think it's part of PB's character arc to, you know, potentially go that way. But yeah, I mean it.
I know. And I'm serious. Serious about us.
Wait, there's an us? Drink to that. Oh, we were in my quarters. I didn't know where we were. Okay. That was pretty cool. Hello again.
How are you? Lexi's been monitoring you since you got off the Archon ship, and she says you're fine, but you were dead, and well, I just want to be sure you're all right.
I'm all right. Don't worry.
You're sweet to worry. I'm fine. I promise. Good. Whatever you need, just ask. Please.
Okay.
I should get back to things. Sounds good?
That accent, though. Let me just check again for anything else. Callow thinks I'm crazy from Suvia. I had a feeling she might have said something. My dearest Pathfinder. Callow thinks I've lost it because I keep smiling and giggling for no reason. Except it's not for no reason. You're the reason, Suvi. Ah! That's adorable. Okay. I gotta say, she's definitely winning me over. PBS, some serious competition. Alright, so, to review. New missions. Oh, we got Codex. First, let me look at Codex. Finding a home. Finding a home. Battle on the Archon's flagship. You save the Krogan trapped aboard the Archon's flagship, but only by leaving Solarian Pathfinder Reka behind. Yes. Keep reminding me. A crew like no other. Lexi. Lexi is concerned about the extent of Sam's control over your body. While she trusts both you and Sam, the fact remains that the AI could stop your heart on command. Yeah, let's hope it remains a good AI, then. Vetra. Okay, I think we send that. Alright. With your recent successes against the cat, Vetra has really begun to believe that, despite all that's come before, you have a chance to make it in Helios. I'll save Suvi for after that. Jal. To save Jal's life, you ended Exul's threat permanently, even though it risks making him a martyr to his cause. Jal is upset that you didn't listen to his warning or trust his advice. Although he's unsure of what a romantic connection with an alien would be like, Jal has been eagerly flirting with you. He seems open to exploring a more intense and intimate relationship. Well, that's too bad for Jal. Sorry. Suvi! Right? Spiritual, similar. It's clear Suvi misses her family and occasionally experiences deep regret at having left them. The growing affection you have for each other, however, has been a genuine comfort. Aww. So cute. The Andromeda Initiative. Pathfinders. Solarian Pathfinder. With Reka captured and presumed dead. She might not be dead, right? Presumed dead. The role of Solarian Pathfinder went to Captain Hager. Though inexperienced by comparison, Hager's record shows steady and skilled leadership of the Solarian Ark. He is now conducting information gathering and research aimed at stopping Ket exaltation. Yeah, he might end up fighting her again as an exalted Solarian stink, but I'm sure we're headed that way. Andromeda species. Ket. The Archon's sword. Huh. Identified in decrypted communications, the cat known as the Archon Sword has a fearsome reputation. Oh, it's one... Okay. It's one being. I thought the Archon Sword was like his... What would you call it? Like a... Special Forces? Not Special Forces. Like a bunch of bodyguards or something. I don't know. Her role as the Archon's enforcer takes her across the Helios Cluster to deliver edicts and quell dissent. Apex reports that those who incur the Archon's displeasure, Ket or otherwise, are pursued relentlessly by the Archon's sword, often never sighted again. In combat, the Archon's sword is said to favor cunning over brute strength, cloaking herself with the same techniques as Ket destined before striking fearlessly. Psychological profiles, though hampered by an incomplete understanding of Ket psychology, suggest she is completely loyal to the Archon and his ideals. Where would you get psychological profiles of this Ket from? We haven't captured them, or her, whatever. Her title has provoked discussion amongst Nexus scientists as it either underlies her devotion to the Archon's cause or it implies a ceremonial and historic role. It is possible that the Archon sword represents a greater tradition within Ket society not fully understood. Anything else? Ket Primus? We learn all this about them? Second in command to the Archon, the Primus is reportedly trusted with leading many of the Ket's most dangerous factions. Apex teams have cited her as a hands-on leader at key Ket positions, and orders from her are treated as coming from the Archon himself. Her main area of responsibility appears to be managing the Ket conquest of Helios via exaltation. Ugh. I hate freaking exaltation. In as much as we can determine with scant details on Ket culture, the Primus is believed to be extremely orthodox. Intercepted and translated reports show her ordering punishments for Ket who deviate from social norms and traditions. She has also repeatedly expressed concerns over the need to break off military exercises or recon missions to investigate remnant technology, suggesting this is not a normal element of Ket expansion. Ket culture. The Ket in the Helios Cluster appear to be a military expeditionary force. Separated from the rest of their culture, only a few conclusions can be drawn about the Ket as a people. Ket society appears to be a strongly regulated hierarchy. DNA evidence suggests genetic lineage is a factor in leadership positions. These ancestral Ket lead the exalted citizens who serve in the army, sciences, or industry. Unskilled labor is performed by slaves, or, as analysis about their home space suggests, conquered vassal species. The Ket interest in the remnant implies a shared history, but details are scarce. Culturally, the Ket are highly ritualized and ceremonial. Intelligence reports show a powerful belief in their genetic and military superiority, and a belief that it benefits lesser species. Even the Ket dialect spoken in Helios, Tanazet, translates to speaking correctly. Exaltation is thus not a punishment, but a means to balance a disordered galaxy by sharing the Ket's genetic perfection. It all seems so much Reaper, you know, like the Reapers wanted to bring everything to order by killing off, you know, not killing off, what do you call it? Yeah, it's all so similar, right? They would absorb the cultures and species, change them genetically. In the Reaper's case, it's like a genetic soup or something like that. And yeah, and they felt that was a good thing. And then you've got all the mutations that the Ket make, which are like the mutations of each race that the Reapers made. It's like they're just trying a different spin on the same thing, really. Major difference, of course, is that the Ket are not AI, or they're, you know, biological life forms. Okay, so ships and vehicles. We got something new here. The Varrakan. The Cat flagship Varrakan is a heavily armed warship that serves as the Archon's central command post for the Cat incursion into the Helios cluster. Heavy main guns and exceptionally powerful kinetic barriers suggest that any frontal assault on the Varrakan without a correspondingly powerful dreadnought would be suicide. The vessel appears to serve as a research center for studying newly captured Milky Way species. Both Krogan and Salarian captives were encountered aboard, indicating the Archon's interest in exalting new species and acquiring their genetic traits. The Varrakan also houses many of the Cat's most important remnant relics, apparently gathered and presented to the Archon for study at his leisure. This fascination was evident in the Archon's private chamber, where he kept a special collection of remnant technology and relics on display. Well, good for him. Good for him. Okay, journal. Okay. The journey to Meridian. The Archon's map shows the way to Meridian. However, this issue affects the entire Andromeda Initiative, and leadership should be consulted before proceeding further. Okay. Okay, we've got allies and relationships. Cora Harper, a foundation. Cora has asked you to accompany her to a site on Eos. Go to Eos with Cora. I'm just trying to sneak up on this stuff so the these little exclamation marks don't go away before I realize it's new. Dissension in the ranks. Nakmor scouts from New Tuchanka have reported Ket ships crashed on Aladdin. They believe this is something that warrants a Pathfinder's attention. Investigate the crash Ket ships on Aladdin. Okay. We got a lot of stuff to do on Aladdin. Tempest. Oh, yeah. Movie night. The right setup. John believes he can create a superior audiovisual setup for movie night with Gil's help and certain Ingarin components. Obtain components from the IR market. I still gotta do this. I might be able to do this now. The relic. The Vold relic. I'm not eager for it. Don't get me wrong. The witnesses. Moshe Sefer urges you to speak with the few remaining Angara on Aya who remember how the Ket conquered their people. The Moshe believes these elders' insights can aid the initiative's struggle against the Ket. I'll highlight that because that'll get lost in all this crap. And that's, yeah. An Asari journalist, Carrie Tavessa, wants to interview you for her documentary about current events. Well, something happened to her. Speak with Carrie's producer. Two more plant samples. Okay. So I think as of now, we're going to go to Aya next and take care of the movie night and talk to those people. Yep, the witnesses. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.